Richard and Matt mentioned the fraudulent hockey stick graph in the last episode. And sorry to say, there have been several other instances of data tampering from institutions like NASA, the UK Climate Authorities, and the Australian Bureau of Meteorology, or BOM.
Right, yeah. I mean, for example, Australia's hottest day on record was 51.7 degrees Celsius at Bourke way back in January 3rd,
1909. That's hot.
BOM claimed it was an anomalous event because the rest of the stations failed to record a similar temperature. But nearby Brawarna recorded 50.6 degrees Celsius on the same day.
Yeah. Well, that's pretty close. And that was more than 100 years ago.
That's right. If the hockey stick graph was accurate, you would think that the record should have been broken many times by recent high temperatures, right?
That's true.
But the second hottest day on record was 51.1 degrees Celsius at White Cliffs on January 12th, 1939. And was also not included in the official digitized records.
More manipulated data. Mm-hmm. Well, here's another one. This graph shows surface temperatures in the U.S. from 1880 to 1998. Notice the high point in the 1930s compared to the second highest in the late 1990s. Mm-hmm. Now look at NASA's surface temperature records for a similar period. Mm-hmm. The 1930 spike was adjusted down, and the 1990 spike was adjusted up, along with other temperatures, making it look like recent temperatures were higher than ever, but they weren't.
Right, and examples like these of climate authorities tampering with the data deceive the public into thinking that there is a problem where there isn't.